जैन स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर ऑनलाइन कंप्यूटर क्लास. यू नो हाफयर एग्जाम इज कमिंग, तो होप यू ऑल नो व्हाट इज द सिलेबस ऑफ हाफयर एग्जाम. आई एम गोइंग टू रिपीट इट अगेन. चैप्टर 3 इंट्रोडक्शन टू क्यू बेसिक एंड चैप्टर 4 डेटा टाइप. बोथ द चैप्टर्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन, प्रैक्टिकल्स ऑल्सो एंड असाइनमेंट्स एंड बैक एक्सरसाइजेस ऑल्सो आई हैव गिवन टू यू. वर्कशीट आई विल प्रोवाइड यू, बट टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज चैप्टर 3 इंट्रोडक्शन टू क्यू बेसिक. सो बी अटेंटिव एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर क्लास. इंट्रोडक्शन टू क्यू बेसिक. स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट ट्राई टू टेक ईच एंड एवरी सेंटेंस in the form of multiple choice questions. Okay, just like what is basic is which type of language, simple language. Okay, so in this way we will proceed today because exam is MCQ based. Okay, all the instruction that we give to the computer must be in capital letter. Okay, the instruction that we write in basic program must be in capital letter, and also all the instruction must start with numbers. Why? Because number will decide the sequence of execution. Okay, and appropriate basic language must be used. If there is a RAM, that should be REM, print, print. Okay, and the instruction that we give to the computer in basic or in any high level language is called program. Also, all program in basic must terminate with which key? Enter key. Now, what is QBASIC? QBASIC is the short form of Quick Basic. What is QBASIC? QBASIC is the short form of Quick Basic. And what is it? It is IDE, Integrated Development Environment. Okay? Why it is called IDE? Because this is the editor where we can write, edit, debug and execute. Hope all of you know the meaning of these words. Write means you are writing the program. Editing means if there is any problem, you are editing the text, and debugging to find the error and executing final run of program. Okay, so full form must be learned to you because question can be asked. QBASIC is the short form of, then option should be Quick Basic, Quick Basic or any other thing. Okay, now which type of language? Basic is high level language. Okay, we have two type of languages, computer programming language. One is low level language and another is high level. So basic is high level language. Okay, now how to start the basic? Just simply double click on the basic icon present on the desktop or in the folder. This is the first screen, welcome screen, that comes in front of you. Just press the escape and you will get this screen. This is the, what is this? This is called QBASIC program window. Okay, and we have this document area where we can write the program, and these are the menus which are nothing but the commands available in the QBASIC. Okay, see what is menu. Menu provide most of the operations. Okay, what we can do with the QBASIC editor. Editor hume kon kon si operations ki permission deta hai, that is given in menu bar. Ab type ke hisab se menu bar divide hoti hai. Okay, like file menu. File menu have sub options like new, open, save, like that. In the same way, we have edit menu, view menu, search, run, debug options. Okay, all of these have different operations. Now, how to write a program? This is the important thing, to write the program in QBASIC. How? QBASIC is consist of various commands. What are the commands? That are nothing but the simply statement that we want to execute. Now, each programming language has certain rules, okay, and rules are called syntax. So according to that syntax we will write the program. And what is our need? If you want to give the comment, we will use rem. If you want to end the program, we will use and, end, and. And if you want to print output, or if you want to show the output to the user, we use print statement. Okay, now statement in QBasic consists of three parts: line number, basic statement and comment line. Okay, now QBasic consists of three parts: line number, basic statement and comment line. See how if we have to write the print, this is the basic syntax. What? Line number, print text. And what is RAM? RAM is to insert a comment in basic program. Actually comment will not shown in output. This is for the use of programmers. कि आपने कहाँ पे क्या किया है इसके instruction को दिखाने के लिए we use RAM. Okay, here तो we have 3-4 lines program, but in actual softwares the program may be of 3000 line, 4000 line, 10000 line. तो how we just search कि किस कोड को किस purpose से लिखा गया. तो for that we have RAM. RAM is for that we have comment. तो in every program we use comment to recognize the code. So this is the use of programmer. Now come to print statement. Print statement rule is it is used to display the data on the output devices. Okay, print statement is used to display the data on the output devices. Now rule for writing: line number, print and text. See, line number, print and text. This is the line number. Line number will decide the sequence of execution. Okay, and print will print is a keyword from the language, and it cannot be changed. It is used to display the text on the output devices. And double quotes, text is enclosed between double quotes. So double quotes is all the text is written in between double quotes. Okay, print cannot be replaced, double quotes cannot be replaced. We can change the line number. Okay, and see, this is your first basic program. What is written? 10 RAM. This is my first QBasic program. Okay, and RAM is not shown in output. Now 20 print, hello everybody, I am starting QBasic, and 30 and. So this is RAM is used for comment, and is used to end the program, and print is used to show the output. Okay, now again come to this here, the rules that we follow to write the commands and statement is called syntax. The syntax of print statement are shown above. Okay, how? This is the syntax of print statement: line number, print and text. Okay, now we cannot change the rules or syntax of any commands and statement according to our program, otherwise computer will not understand what we are trying to say in given error, and any error in syntax is called syntax error. Okay, so we cannot change the rule or syntax of any commands. The words written in a small letter can be replaced, but the words that are written in capital letters and highlighted cannot be replaced. Okay, all the commands and keywords like this print and RAM and end, these cannot be replaced. Okay, otherwise QBasic program will give you error message. Okay, when you run the program it will give you error message. Now one more thing, why it is written 10, 20, 30 instead of written 1, 2, 3? You know? Yes. Because if we write 10, 20, 30, we have some more line numbers to insert more lines in between these. Okay? If we write 1, 2, 3, we cannot insert the line. We have to change the whole code. Okay? if we have written in this way, we can insert a line in between any of these numbers, okay, because there is a space. Now see with example, like what is written in first place, program code 10 print, this is an example, 20 and, okay, this is an example. Simply print is done in line number 10 and then and is 20, output is, this is an example. Now I want to insert one more line, to where I will write just simple, after the program I will give the number 15 and write the line 15 print, I want to add a line. This is written after and, but computer will take it before and. Why? Because its line number is 15, less than 20. Okay, so there is a space between 10 and 20. We can insert 9 lines in between 10 to 20. Okay, computer, this program will be, computer will show the program in this way. See, 10 print, this is an example, 15 print, I want to add a line, and then 20 and. Okay, see, just have a look on this. Now one more thing, after typing program nothing will done until you will run it. Got it? After running you can check your output only. Okay, so for that we have run command, and F5. Now some more example of print command. Simply whatever you want to print, just write in between double quotes after print. So what is the program code? 10 print, here print is a command, and output will be, here print is a command. Then again, if you write the mathematical expression, that will be printed as it is. Why? Because there is a double quotes. If you write any mathematical expression between double quotes, then it is printed as it is. Okay, here we have written 10 print, double quotes 12 plus 2, the output will be 12 plus 2. Okay, now see, if we will remove this double quotes, what happened? Just see, in this program there is a double quotes after print. Okay, so 12 plus 2 will be printed as output because this is enclosed between double quotes. Now this can be written in this way, if here double quotes is removed, so 10 print 12 plus 2, double quotes is not there, so then print statement will execute this mathematical expression and give you output of it, answer as a output. Okay, now 12 plus 2 will be 14, and here because of double quotes it is printed as it is. Here there is no double quotes, so it will print it, it will print its result, the mathematical expression of the result. Now some more examples on print. 10 print, I am learning computers. 20 print, I am learning about basic. The output will be, I am learning computers, I am learning about basic. Okay, now the, see the second program code, 10 print, double quotes 12 plus 3, 20 print 2 plus 3 and. So what will be the output for line number 10? It is 2 plus 3. And what will be the output for line number 20? Because there is a no double quote, so its print will execute as a mathematical expression and give you output, answer as a output. Okay, so what is written here? 2 plus 3, 5. Okay, now in a print statement, all alphabets and symbols other than plus, minus, multiplication, division should be put inside quotation. Numbers can be put within or without quotation. Okay, see, whenever you type inside the double quotes, it will be displayed as it is. Alphabet characters and symbols have to be placed inside the quote. whatever you type in the double quotes, it will be displayed as it is. Okay, alphabets and characters are displayed inside it. But when it is the case of numbers, numbers can be without quotation and with quotation. Without quotation, numbers are taken for calculations, and if in numbers are placed inside the quotation, then it is printed as it is. There will be no calculation on it. Okay, and if we want to calculate any mathematical expression like 2 plus 3, 5 minus 2, 6 multiplied by 10 or 10 divided by 2, whatever, okay, then there should be no double quotes. The mathematical expression can be written in the same way. Okay, now see the example. 10 print double quotes 2, 20 and. So what will be the output? It is 2. And here also 10 print 2. What will be the output? 2. Because this is simply a number. You can put it inside the double quotes or without it. Okay. Now, see the example. 10 print 35 equal to 67. Okay. See. Here there is a no double quotes, and in second program 10 print I am a good student. Here also there is a no double quotes. Okay, so it will give you syntax error. Why it will give you error? Because other than number, other than any mathematical equation, you have to put the inside the double quotes, otherwise it will give you syntax error. Now see, in both example we'll get an error message. Okay, we'll get this error because we do not follow the syntax of the print statement. Okay, in the example we should use inside the quotation. 10 print 35 equal to 67. This should be written in between double quotes, so output will be this. In the same way, 10 print I am a good student, output will be I am a good student. Okay. Now, there are something that is used in print statement to put the gap. What are that symbols? If you want to put the gap between the words, then we use comma. Okay, we are printing two words and we want to put gaps in between them. What we have to do? We have to put comma in between them. Okay, so question can be asked that if you want to put the gap between two words in what you can use, the answer should be comma. Okay, next we have tab. So tab, why tab is used? Tab is used with the print statement. The output will be positioned on the screen, means output will be shifted. How? Just use write line number, then print and tab, and number of steps you want to display your word. So you can write 20, 30, 50, whatever you want, and after that semicolon and then the word, then output will be displayed from the here it is 20 position displayed from the output screen. Okay, and so we have three things. One is comma, another is semicolon, and third is tab. When we use comma, there should be a zonal gap in between words, and when we use semicolon, there is no gap between the words, and when we use tab, okay, it will reposition the word from the screen. Okay, so the question can be asked, when tab is used with the print statement, the output will be how, with gap, without gap, or repositioning. So you can answer reposition. In the same way, here also we want to put the zonal gap, you will put comma, semicolon, or anything else. So answer should be semicolon, answer should be comma, because semicolon will not give you any gap, will not put any gap. Okay students, I think that's all for this chapter. Okay students, that's all for this chapter. I'm going to give you a worksheet, MCQ based worksheet after this class. Revise it. In next class we'll discuss the answers, and maybe there will be a surprise test for you. So be ready for it and read the chapter thoroughly. Okay, that's all for today. Have a nice day. Take care.